What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to the channel where we talk about everything Amazon FBA. As you can see, a little bit of a change of scenery. I am in my new office in the new house. On the previous video, I talked about the fact that I was back and I'm back creating videos for you guys here on YouTube, and that is 100% true. And so in today's video, we're going to be talking about the biggest Amazon mistakes that I've made as an Amazon seller. The things that I actually did in my first year of selling that, in my opinion, actually stopped my growth and made it so that I did not have nearly the amount of sales that I potentially could have. And I want to share these things with you so you don't make the same mistakes that I did and you can actually avoid them in your own Amazon journey. Let's get into it. Alright guys, so as I mentioned, today's video is all about the biggest mistakes to avoid when selling on Amazon. So I have went and made these mistakes and I'm here to share them with you so that you don't have to go ahead and make all of the same mistakes that I already did. So let's hop right into it and start chatting about those. So the first mistake that you're going to want to avoid when selling on Amazon is improper product research. So this is absolutely massive, probably the most important one, just for the fact that you want to be confident in the products that you are selling and you want to do your research up front to know exactly how the product is going to sell and have a very good idea of the profit that you're going to make from that product and how long it's actually going to take you before you can sell out of that product. By using software tools that are commercially available, such as Keepa, Jungle Scout, RevSeller, and a few other tools that I use within my own business, you're able to quickly identify what products are going to be heroes and which products are ultimately going to be zeros. And by doing the product research upfront, by putting in that work before you actually spend your hard-earned money and time shipping the product, inspecting the product, putting it out to Amazon, and getting it all listed on your listing, you're gonna wanna make sure that it is a good product to sell. So this goes for if you're selling retail arbitrage, online arbitrage, wholesale, private label, it doesn't matter. You need to do your product research first and you need to make sure it's the type of product that you want to be selling before you go out ahead and actually do so. The second mistake that I made as an Amazon seller in the beginning was not focusing on one method. I think this is extremely important, and it's not to say that you down the line should not be focusing on more than one method, whether that be online arbitrage, retail arbitrage, wholesale, private label, but I think in the beginning, it is very, very important to choose one of those methods and actually just stick with it. Pick the method that feels right to you, that you have the most knowledge of, and that you're able to see yourself operating within. Wholesale in my case, and the students that I help and teach, and stick with it. Please stick with it until such time that you actually are starting to see success with it. And then once you're starting to become successful, you're comfortable with the business model, you know exactly what to expect day to day, month to month, year to year even, then you can start hopping out into some of these other methods. In the beginning, when I first started, I was doing online arbitrage, and then I got into wholesale, and then I was trying some retail arbitrage while I was doing wholesale. In my opinion, it really inhibited me from really learning wholesale and really understanding what the business model was, because my time, my attention, my focus was drawn to these other business models. I wasn't able to fully immerse myself in wholesale. And starting an Amazon business, and a mistake you absolutely want to avoid, is only selling fast-moving products. I know it seems a little bit counterintuitive, but focusing only on the very fast moving products that you can turn over very, very quickly is absolutely a massive mistake. You should not overlook some of the medium to slow selling products, as generally those will have some higher profit margins. You're going to overall have much less competition on these products in these categories. You're likely going to run into less issues if you're doing one of the arbitrage or wholesale methods, with brands coming after you, Amazon coming after you, problems with selling products. And the last point to consider is obviously the profit margin. So slimmer profit margins on very fast selling products for a couple of reasons. One of those being usually large sellers or Amazon themselves are on the very, very fast moving products. Generally, they have a much higher purchasing power. They have a higher threshold for having slim margins or even losing profit on margins just to assert dominance on listings. So generally, you're gonna make less money selling fast moving products. And as well, it's really tough to keep up with the demand of very fast selling products. We live in a day and age where restock limits or the amount of inventory you can actually send into Amazon is limited. And because of that, we want to be very intelligent, very selective with the products that we're actually sending in, not sending hundreds and thousands of units of a product that we're going to make 3 or 5% margin on. So we want to make sure that we're effectively maximizing both our capital and our restock limits when selling products. So if at all possible, it's good to have those fast selling products, the things that turn your money over quickly, but make sure you're not overlooking those medium and slow selling products as well. Another mistake that I see people making is not testing products before sending them to market. So one of the things that I preach and one of the things that I instill in my students is testing products. So when you go through my course, Elite Wholesale, you can go check it out if you want some more information in the description below. I teach students to, generally speaking, set up accounts with distributors, brands, and wholesalers that have agreements, accounts, and supply chains that can actually replenish products. So because of the fact that we're doing a lot of replenishable products, meaning we can order them over and over and over again, it is a very intelligent decision to always test buy products. So remember back the first mistake that we talked about not doing product research? Well, the next thing I'm gonna say is doing proper product research, but also validating that with real data. That's the only way to know that you're actually going to be selling a product, that you're actually going to make good profit, and that you're actually going to be able to stay competitive on that product long-term, is testing the products out. All right, guys, that is all I have for today's video. Those have been all of the mistakes to avoid that I did make within my first year of selling. I'm not going to go ahead and say those are the only mistakes I've made, because God knows I have made dozens, hundreds, probably thousands of mistakes in my life, and my business is no exception. Those are the mistakes that are most prevalent in my mind and the contributing factors to me not growing quite as fast as I probably could have within my first year. So I hope this was action-packed and full of value for you guys. If you guys like my content, please make sure to stop by and smash that like button down below. Absolutely free to do, and it does help out the channel more than you could ever know. As well, if you have any questions or comments, any mistakes that you made within your first year of selling, or even your fifth year of selling, drop them down in the comment section. I would love to see some of the other mistakes. Maybe we can help some other people avoid those mistakes going forward as well. And as always, if you guys are not already, make sure that you are subscribed and hitting that notification bell so you can be notified every single time that I post a new video. Other than that is all I have for you guys. I hope that you're having a fantastic day, and peace.